Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 39 of our GoLang course. This particular lesson is going to be a little theoretically heavy. In this lesson, we will go over why we use pointers. So let's get started. In programming, a variable is a name storage location that can hold a value. The categorization of a variable is either mutable or immutable based on whether or not their values can be changed after they have been assigned. Please note, we are not talking about Go variables, but variables in the context of programming in general. Just to recap, mutable variables are those whose values can be modified after they have been initially assigned. This means you can update or alter the value stored in a mutable variable as needed during the course of program's execution. On the other hand, immutable variables do not allow their values to be modified once they have been assigned. Once an immutable variable is assigned a value, the value cannot be changed throughout the program's execution. We already went over the const keyword and how you can use it to declare a constant in Go. Constants are immutable by nature and cannot be changed after they have been defined. Conversely, using a var keyword declares a variable that can be reassigned with a new value, making it mutable within a function scope or the package scope where it has been defined. Now let's go over how pointers relate to mutability. When a function needs to modify the value of a variable that was passed as an argument to it, it requires the use of pointers. Pointers allow the function to access and modify the original variable in memory directly. By passing the memory address or the pointer of a variable to a function, the function gains the capability to access and alter the content of that variable directly. This is particularly useful when you want the function to modify the original data rather than working with a copy. While mutability can be powerful, it also introduces the potential for unintended side effects or bugs. It's crucial to carefully manage mutability and ensure the functions clearly document their behavior, especially when they have the potential to alter the state of the variable or the parameter that they have been passed. Another use of pointers in Go is indication of no values. In some cases, it's crucial for the calling function to differentiate between the variable that has a valid value, even if it's a zero value, and a situation where no values has been returned or provided. This distinction is significant for accurate programming behavior. This is where pointers come into play. When a function returns a pointer, it may use nil to indicate that no valid value has been returned. This is particularly useful for functions that operate on optional data or in cases where a function might not be able to provide a valid result. We will see this in a future lesson, but in Go, it's a common practice to return both a value and an error from a function. In situations where there is no valid value to return, the function can return nil as the value to signify the absence along with the appropriate error. This pattern ensures clear error handling in Go code. Next, let us talk about some performance benefits of using pointers. When you pass a large struct as an argument to a function, it can be inefficient in terms of memory and performance. This is because the entire structure needs to be copied over to the function, which can be resource intensive. Instead of passing the entire struct, you can pass a pointer to the struct. This way, you are essentially passing the memory address of where the struct is stored rather than making a full copy. If you remember from our past lesson, the size of pointer is same for any data type. This can significantly improve the performance, especially for large data structures. While using pointers can improve performance in some cases, it is important to balance this with code readability and maintainability. Passing value is often simpler and more intuitive. Only resort to using pointers when performance gain is significant enough to justify the added complexity. Please remember, passing pointer also gives the function that you are passing the pointer to the ability to mutate the value of the variable. With experience, you will know where to pass a pointer. In addition, linting tools in Go can provide recommendations and warnings about code practices. This can also help you identify a situation where using a pointer for performance optimization is warranted and where it may be unnecessary or even detrimental. This can guide you in making informed decisions about when to use pointers. This is one of the core features of Go, which is Go is garbage collected. In Go, memory management is handled automatically by a garbage collector. This means that developers don't need to manually allocate or deallocate memory, which can be source of bugs and complexity in other languages. The garbage collector keeps track of unused memory and reclaims it when necessary. When you create a pointer in Go, it typically refers to a memory location in the heap. This is where dynamic memory allocation takes place. Unlike the stack, which manages function call execution, the heap is used for storing data with a potentially longer lifespan. While Go's garbage collector automates memory management, it is still crucial to write efficient code. Excessive use of dynamic memory allocation, example, creating many short-lived objects, can potentially put strain on garbage collector. Being mindful of memory use and optimizing code can lead to better performance. Again, I know this lesson has been quite theoretical, but I think it's really important to go over the theory before practicing code. So that is usually my aim with theoretical lessons, so that you have a strong basis to work on the code. Let's now summarize whatever we have learned in this lesson. We have seen that pointers are a versatile feature in Go. They can be used to signal that a variable's value may change, indicating mutability, or to represent the absence of value using nil value. And we also learned that it can improve performance in cases where passing a memory address instead of a copy of a value is more efficient. Passing values directly to a function is generally simpler and more intuitive. It keeps the code clear and easy to understand. Pointers can add complexity, so they should be only used when there is a clear advantage or specific requirement. While Go has a garbage collector that automatically manages memory, it's still important to write code that uses memory efficiently. Minimizing unnecessary allocations on the heap can improve performance of your program. This is particularly useful in performance-critical application. That's it for the lesson. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. I will be happy to respond to your queries. Thanks for watching the lesson. I will see you in the next lesson, where we will go over some of these concepts with a Go program. Thanks again. Happy coding.